Behold, this scroll without a name. Within it is recounted an as yet unfinished tale. If thy heart be drawn to its contents, take up the scroll and unfurl its aged parchment. I see thou art keen to know more. In that case, allow me to spin for thee a yarn. A tale spanning the history of the ninja. The story of a never-ending chain of battles. Raging ceaselessly since creation itself, before even the days of the Atsutsuki. Even as ninja formed clans and villages and settled into prosperity.
Coming down!
Take this. Tailed beast in Susanoo. I would say we're both plenty warmed up, wouldn't you?
Indeed.
Prepare to fight. This is why I could never stop fighting.
Susanoo isn't invincible.
Not bad, Hashirama. But this isn't over yet.
choice. Sage Art, Wood Style, Shinsu Senshu, Veritable Thousand Arm Kanon.
The battle will never end. But still the ninja keep up the fight. They fight for what they believe in, to follow their own true path. Land of Fire, Hidden Leaf Village. There stood a boy whose clan had been eradicated by his own elder brother. A boy by the name of Sasuke Uchiha. He lived for a period of time in peace, but as soon as he began walking down the path of revenge, he slipped into darkness. And finally succeeded in conquering his brother, Itachi Uchiha. But his brother's words had all been lies. The Hidden Leaf was the real enemy. Soon, the tiny flames of hatred grew into the inferno that was the fourth great ninja war. And as the terrible conflict erupted, as he dashed toward the battlefield, Sasuke Uchiha saw someone completely unexpected. His brother had been revived into the physical world. Over time, the two came to terms with each other and were finally brothers once more. And then, after succeeding in what he came to do, Itachi disappeared into the light.
I will always love you.
Leaving just one line of truth with his little brother.
There you are.
See, it's... And Jugo?
We've been looking all over for you.
So, what do you want with me? Why did you come all this way to find me?
Well, the thing is, we just happened upon a mind-blowing scroll in Orochimaru's hideout. Take a look. Well, pretty amazing, huh?
Yes. They're the ones with all the answers. There's someone I need to see now.
Who's that?
Orochimaru.
Huh? What are you talking about? You iced his ass.
You know Orochimaru, you really think that'd be enough to vanquish him? Jugo, bring that woman too.
Who is she?
A hidden leaf ninja Kabuto kidnapped. The seal absorbed Orochimaru's chakra. We'll just use that to summon Orochimaru back.
Whoa, hold on. Reviving Orochimaru is way too dangerous. Huh?
Curse unsealing!
Thinking. Feeling better now, Orochimaru? Had enough?
I've limbered up. Yes. That'll do for now. Fighting him made me realize that he's a bit different from before. So,
there's something I want you to do for me, Orochimaru.
Yes, you really don't need to explain all that. I've been watching him the whole time, remember? And when you meet them, then what?
I know too little. I want them to tell me everything.
You needn't trouble yourself with all that. You're still just a child after all.
No. I'm not a child, not anymore. I can't be a child. I need to know how it all began. I need to know who I should be, what I should be doing. I want to know everything, so I can decide what it all means for myself. I want to make my own judgments, then I'll decide what needs to be done.
I think I quite like you now. Very well. I'll help you. Come with me.
Where to?
Oh, to a place you know very well indeed. Come, let's go.
Thank you.
knew there was all this going on under the leaf shrine.
Now, let's begin. Reaper Death Seal, release! This mask is necessary in order to use the jutsu written in that scroll. Using this calls out the Reaper, which then possesses the user. Then we can release the things that were sealed by the Reaper. Jugo, Sasuke, Suiketsu, get ready! Now, Jugo, use your chakra to make the extraction from Sasuke. That should draw out the spores of the Zetsu that Tobi set as Sasuke's watchdog. They'll serve as the sacrifices to summon the four. Reanimation Jutsu! Come now. Come! The ones who know everything. The former Hokage!
The first Hokage? Hashirama Senju, feared as the god of all ninja in the flesh.
What's going on here?
The Reaper Death Seal. They must have released it somehow. And then used reanimation.
Looks like we've been brought back to life, first Hokage.
Reanimation again? Everyone seems to have no trouble using the jutsu I invented.
There's a reason for this. I simply prepared all this to grant his wishes.
My name is Sasuke Uchiha. I have some questions for you, Hokage.
What? Sasuke?
First of all, third. Why did you make my brother do what he did?
I see. So you know.
I still want to hear it from your mouth. Everything about Itachi.
He killed his fellow clan members and stopped a coup. The man single-handedly prevented a war. He even installed himself in the Akatsuki as a spy after that, to keep the village safe. All under the condition that I protect you, his younger brother.
So it was really true. Now, first, I ask you. What is the village? What does it mean to be a ninja? Itachi, my brother, was prepared to protect the hidden leaf with his life, despite knowing he'd been used by the village. And he was proud to be a shinobi of the leaf. What does it mean to give up your own life to protect a village? And what about the ninja that creates such a situation and believe that it's okay? I want to hear it from you. I want to hear the truth so I can decide for myself. Should I take revenge on the village, or...?
Revenge on the village? You think I'm just going to let you...?
Tobirama! Lower your hand.
Fine.
Well, excuse me. Well, you want to know about the village, you say? I'd be glad to tell you what you want to know, but it might take some time.
No. Please just tell the boy what he wants to know as quickly as possible.
What do you mean?
We're in the middle of a war here. Madara Uchiha has come back to life and is trying to destroy every last ninja in the world.
Yes, I can sense a powerful chakra presence at 2 o'clock.
The second Hokage is right. I'm picking up some intense chakra too. But it's not just that. No, I think... this feeling. Naruto, you're fighting too, aren't you?
If Madara's back, talking will have to wait. We can't afford to sit around here and do nothing.
I'm sorry, but if you want to head to the battlefield, I must insist we finish our conversation first. If you can't provide Sasuke with the answers he desires, I wouldn't put it past him to use you all to destroy the Hidden Leaf.
Damn you, Orochimaru!
Don't worry, Orochimaru. We understand. Our first priority should be finding a way to ease up what's binding him. So, where should I begin? Well, in order to explain what a village and a ninja are, I must first explain about the two clans, the Uchiha and the Senju. We fought and fought. Both of us were at the very end of our ropes. And we both knew the end had to be in sight for one of us. It's over, Madara.
Then finish me. Can't do it? That is your problem, Hashirama. You're soft. Yeah.
I'll do anything to protect our... No, to protect my village, no matter what happens. I believe that protecting the village means protecting the people of the Hidden Leaf, the ninja, the children. I don't care who it is. my friend, my brother, or my own child. I won't forgive anyone who threatens it.
You have your priorities mixed up. That will create darkness in the village. Someday.
That's when I found my resolve. My resolve to protect the village to the bitter end. I don't know how he resurrected himself now, but I buried my friend for good that day, for the sake of the village. Which brings me to the village itself. What Madara and I envisioned at first was a place for clans to come together and connect. A way to bring order out of chaos, and keep it that way. It was a place where our children could be safe, where no pointless battles were fought, a place of peace. But the fact is, it created a darkness like the one that your brother Itachi bore. Perhaps Madara was right. Perhaps he saw all that coming. I'm the one who created that situation. I'm the only one who gave it the okay. You see, to me, a ninja is someone who bears anything necessary to achieve his goal. However, a ninja is also shaped by what sort of goal he strives for. Just like Madara and I.
A ninja is someone who bears whatever it takes to reach his goal.
That's what I built the village on. But Madara had a different ideal. I don't know about Madara's current resurrection. I don't know what's behind this idea of his to wipe out the world's ninja, but...
Infinite Tsukuyomi. Regardless of clan, creed, country, or anything. He wants to trap everyone in a genjutsu so he can make things happen exactly as he desires. Everything my brother and you fought so hard to protect. He wants to destroy it all.
Then we can't afford to stay here a moment longer.
Now that you've heard the first Hokage's explanation, what do you intend to do with it? Will you turn your blade toward the hidden leaf? Or...
Sasuke, forgive me. I always lied to you. I asked you to forgive me. Even as I kept pushing you away, I didn't want to pull you in. But now I think of it this way. Maybe you could have changed father, mother, the Uchiha clan, if I'd faced you honestly from the very beginning. If we'd told each other the truth as equals. I failed. I won't put myself above you and tell you this and that. It's too late. So this time, for once, let me tell you one small truth. It's all right if you never forgive me. But, no matter what you become, I will always love you.
I'm going into battle. The village, Itachi. I won't let it all be in vain.
Well said. Come then, there's no time to lose.
So, that's the path you've chosen. Now, show me what you're capable of. Sasuke Uchiha. your new wind.
Do you remember what we talked about here when we were kids?
Yes. Although at the time, I really thought you were joking.
How cold. I'm not the kind of man who makes a joke about something like that.
You really were a strange one, though. What was it now? A school for the children? A safe village for your brothers? I remember thinking that you had some pretty grand plans for a little kid.
Oh?
But they weren't bad dreams. They were the same as mine. Which is why I am here with you today.
Yes.
The Hidden Leaf Village. This village has become precious to me, and I must protect it.
So, have you thought about my Hokage idea some more?
What? You were being serious about that? I thought you were just pulling my leg.
What? No, I was being deadly serious. You would be perfect for the position. You'll be the leader of the village and guide everyone forward. And we'll carve a model of your face in the cliff here, as an emblem of the village.
Hey, I never agreed to that. It's not my style.
It's not up to you. The more embarrassed you are, the better.
You're just trying to torture me here, aren't you? Very smart. It is a fine outfit.
Well, it was supposed to be yours. I still think you'd make a better Hokage than I will.
Well, it was a democratic decision. The villagers chose you. You are the Hokage.
Madara.
This stone has been passed down through generations of the Uchiha clan. It can be deciphered only by those with special eye abilities. This is as much as I can read so far. Seeking stability, there was a god who split into two halves, light and dark. Bringing the two halves together again grants the user the power of all creation. In other words, bringing two opposing forces together as one will lead to true happiness. But you can take it another way, too.
Huh?
Never mind. There is no point in talking to you about it now.
What do you mean?
Hashirama, I am leaving the village. We are history.
Huh? Why?
I do not have any allies here. No one looks up to me.
But I can't do this without you. I need you as my right-hand man, as a brother. The people will soon come to see you for what you are. And when they do, you can be the second Hokage.
I should think Tobirama will be your successor. If that happens, my clan will be doomed. I have tried to warn the other Uchiha of the danger and get them to leave the village. Save your breath. I am leaving. I have found another way.
Wait, they're just misunderstanding you.
Let us just say it comes down to how you perceive reality. Anyway, enough with the groveling. It is far healthier to see this world as a playground.
Hey, are you listening to me?
You are the only one who can stand up to me.
Mother!
Until I reach the path to my true dream.
Ugh!
I shall enjoy fighting with you.
What is your true dream? Why wouldn't you explain it to me?
Lord Hokage!
What is it?
It's Madara Uchiha! He's coming!
What? Really? He's come back?
He's attacking the village! He wiped out the Vanguard unit. We sent a second and third, but we've had reports of heavy casualties. We're working on evacuating the villagers. We just can't stop Madara's advance. What are we going to do? Hokage!
What's the meaning of this? Why would... Madara, we built this place together, you and me. Why would you? It doesn't make sense. I can't understand you anymore. I can't... understand.
Ambitions and machinations swirled in the dark night. Had the emotions of yesterday already run dry? Was despair the only thing that awaited? With unspeakable pain in his heart, Hashirama Senju challenged his friend. Believing that in this deep abyss, there was one last sliver of hope.
Now that's a sight for sore eyes.
I knew it was you, Sasuke!
Cutting.
I thought I sensed your chakra, so I busted out of jail to come and check. How dare you betray me like that? Oh, why, Sasuke?
Once he took you hostage, you became a burden.
I'm never gonna forgive you for what you've done!
Sorry.
You think sorry is gonna cut it after everything you've put me through? I... You good for nothing!
I see you're as weak as always when it comes to Sasuke, Karin.
Judging from the color of her hair, she must be from the Uzumaki clan. Sure brings back memories. My wife was from that same clan.
Much as I enjoy hearing my brother reminiscing, save it for later.
Yes, you're right. We must get to the battlefield as soon as possible.
No, there's something we need to do first. We can head to the battlefield. However, I'm doubtful as to whether we should be taking this lot along with us.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, if you're going to get under our feet, you should just stay away.
That's how you see us, is it?
Not you, Orochimaru. You're fine. But the others...
Then why don't you put them to the test?
I intend to,
Very well. I'm in too. It will do me good to move my limbs a bit before the battle. Sarutobi, join us. Let's all fight together. It's been too long.
Understood.
Then it's decided. Sasuke, Jugo, and Suigetsu. Show them what you can do.
What? Why me?
Karin's a healer. You men are the combat specialists, aren't you? And where is this test to take place? Surely not here.
Don't be ridiculous. We'll go to the place Hashirama and I used to use for training.
Ah, yes. We shouldn't be disturbed here. Good.
So, the three of us have decided to test your strength as fighters. If you fail to impress us...
Save the explanations. Let's just do this.
Hey, stop taunting them!
Suits me. We don't have much time. Oh, impressive. He's covering himself perfectly. This should be fun. See what you've got.
This seems kind of scary.
Wooden dragon!
Push them right to the brink before we... What are you playing around for? Water slide! Water shockwave!
be me. Won't be able to hold on forever.
Not bad. Wood style, wood expulsion jutsu. Now, what will it be? Yes, that will do.
So, how do we do?
I imagine Madara will be surprised to see such powerful ninja arrive.
In other words?
I suppose this means you passed.
Yes. I admit that you're stronger than I imagined.
Whoa!
Now then, the other group is waiting. Back to the village!
Aha! Sasuke!
Sorry to keep you waiting.
How did they do?
Oh yes, excellent. We'll all be heading straight to the battlefield. Hokage! It's time at last. As we stand atop the mountainside images that have long watched over the Hidden Leaf, let the sight of the village be imprinted in our minds as we charge into battle to defend it.
I'll be able to see my son at last, Naruto. I haven't been able to be much of a father to you, so I'm going to try to make it up to you now. I'm bringing a big present with me.
I haven't fought a war in a long time. I'd better keep my wits about me.
Madara, I'm going to defeat you once and for all.
I know it's inappropriate, but I can't deny that I'm excited about seeing my old friend again. There's always fighting in this world. But this is going to be the last war. To battle!
Land of Fire, Hidden Leaf Village. Here lives a boy who dreams of becoming the village leader, the Hokage. That boy's name is Naruto Uzumaki. In his body dwell the nine-tailed fox, the mighty-tailed beast that once attacked the village, but the strong will that he was born with allowed him to run down the path of growth. However, there was trouble brewing in the ninja world. An organization known as the Akatsuki had set out to collect the nine-tailed beasts, including the nine tails, and declared war on the ninja world, releasing the flames of a massive conflict. Once they were ignited, the flames continued to burn on and on. But Naruto Uzumaki just kept staring straight ahead. Having forged new bonds, he kept his eyes fixed on the future and let loose a roar. That roar grew stronger and spread. And as if they were echoes, his many allies leapt into action.
Naruto.
All for his sake, as he keeps on fighting.
This world is meaningless now.
The ghetto statue here? Don't tell me he's ready to begin.
Now, time for chaos!
The roars from the splitting earth herald the end. As this battle to save the ninja world enters its final stage. The ultimate deathmatch begins.
The world no longer needs hope, a future, or any famous heroes.
When this reality ends, all that will remain is a single endless dream.
I had a dad, a mom, an old man sage. Kids look up to heroes. So I'm gonna keep charging ahead without losing my way. I'm gonna become the best Hokage there's ever been! That's my dream, you idiot!
Kakashi.
Tail Beast Bomb!
You're too late. You're wasting your time. What?
Impossible!
Nowhere to run now, Toby!
I get it. My attack is what erased that shadow clone. It was Kamui. Damn Kakashi. He figured out that we're connected to the same space.
This is it! Who are you?
You're... Obito. I knew it, but I didn't want to believe it. I wanted to be wrong. I mean, back then, you were a hero.
It was during the Third Great Ninja War. An age when men and women, young and old, anyone who was known as ninja, flew headlong into battle. They drew blood, shed their bonds, stole things, and lost their own. This cycle of hatred spread like wildfire, endlessly. And in the center stood three fledgling youths. They too were ninja. Embroiled in this terrible war, putting their lives on the line.
How are you always so late? Ninja have rules. You need to stick to the plan. A good ninja sticks to the rules and does everything by the book.
Rules, doing things by the book, that's all you ever talk about. Don't you have any compassion?
Any ninja that breaks the rules sullies their name. You can at least understand that, right?
Okay, okay, you two. Give it a rest. We're on the same team, remember?
Rin, you're too soft on Obito. Today's a very important day for us.
Yeah, that's true.
Huh? What's going on?
Phew. Let's talk about it on the way to our destination. As of today, Kakashi's become a jonin, like me. We'll split into two units, led by Kakashi and myself, in order to give us the best chance of success. We're suffering from the biggest lack of manpower that the Hidden Leaf Village has ever seen. Remember?
Actually, Obito, remember our talk about giving Kakashi a present? I already gave him a medkit, and Sensei's also...
I gave him a custom-made kunai knife. Just like the one I carry.
What about you, Obito?
Sorry, I forgot.
What?
Well, I wasn't expecting anything from you anyway. It probably would have just been a piece of junk. Useless crap like that would just be excess baggage.
Hey!
Oh, come on, don't start fighting!
Now, let me run through the mission. You're all aware that the Land of Earth has launched an invasion against the village hidden in the grass, right?
Yes, they're coming very fast. It's only a matter of time before they cross into the Land of Fire.
That's why we need to stop them as soon as possible. As such, our mission this time is to infiltrate enemy territory and destroy the Kanabi Bridge, which is part of their supply route.
So we're going to cut off the enemy's support network.
What about you, Sensei?
I'm going to tackle them head-on and act as a diversion for you. For today, Kakashi is your leader. We'll stick together until we hit the border, but after that,
Your unit's on its own.
Gotcha. Okay.
They noticed me, did they? Impressive.
Careful now, everyone. There's 20 of them, although there's a good chance they're using Shadow Clone Jutsu.
I'm going in. Cover me.
Not so fast, Kakashi. You should act as backup.
What about what you said before, Sensei? I'm the leader today. That means I call the shots, doesn't it? That's the rule.
Okay, everyone. Follow Kakashi's lead.
Okay.
Good. No sign of any reinforcements. Kakashi's really worn out. Let's retreat for now and regroup.
I'm fine.
Fine my ass? That's what you get for ignoring Sensei and doing whatever you like.
That's some talk, coming from a ninja who is too scared to be of any help.
I wasn't scared. It was just, you know, I had a tummy ache. I'll be fine next time.
That's all that ever comes out of your mouth. Excuses.
Enough already, you two. You're going to have to work together from now on if you want to complete your missions. Right now, you're pulling in opposite directions. Yes, Kakashi, rules in the ninja code are important, but they aren't everything. It's like I taught you. Sometimes you've got to adapt to the situation you're in and bend the rules. And Obito, you still haven't truly prepared yourself to be a ninja. Your spirit is weak. That's why you feel scared when you actually face the enemy. I've got faith in you all, though. I know that you can complete this mission on your own. But if you cannot work together and function as a team, you're going to fail. Before I go, one more thing. The most important thing any ninja has to master is teamwork. Got it?
With heartbeats racing, without a clear vision of what was really right and wrong, trapped in a battle with no exit, the boys just kept moving forward, running as fast as they could.
Okay, time to split up. Good luck, everyone. Disperse!
After parting with Minato, Kakashi's team headed straight for their target, Kanabi Bridge. Sometimes arguing, sometimes working together, moving ever forward. Finally, several days later, with their target in sight, the three took their final break. Moving into enemy territory had made them extremely tense. That was when it happened.
Rain!
She's coming with us.
Hey, what did you do to her?
Don't worry, she's just asleep. We'll be able to get a lot out of her.
Let her go! No! Come on, Kakashi, we gotta go after them! Hey, Kakashi! Kakashi?
The two of us need to carry on with the mission by ourselves.
What? Do you know what you're saying?
Yes.
But Rin, what about Rin?
We'll think about Rin later. They want to know what our plan is, so they won't kill her straight away. We should be more worried about them learning our tactics. To a ninja, his mission is everything. That's the ninja code.
The ninja code? There's something way more important than that stupid code! What about Rin? She's one of our comrades! She's helped us time and time again with her medical ninjutsu. She supported us the entire time! She's a priceless friend!
She did that because it was part of her mission.
Forget it. You and I just don't get along. There's no point in discussing it anymore.
You don't get it. You don't know what happens to people who break the code.
Sure, maybe in the ninja world, those who break the rules are scum. But you know what? Someone who doesn't care about their friends is even worse. I'm going to help Rin.
She's trapped in a genjutsu. If you want to free her, you'll need to defeat us. But there's no way you could do that.
Rain, I promise.
Must have taken a lot of courage to come here alone. Sometimes courage just isn't enough. Know what I mean? Unfortunately, your life ends here.
My arm's still shaking. I'm only afraid because you're weak, Obito. Over it! Green.
Think you're close to rescuing your friend? Huh? I knew it. You think like a kid. You really think someone like me would fight seriously against a kid? You don't know when to give up, do you? Maybe you're not as useless as I thought you were. Come on, quit playing games, Taisuke.
I will.
Camouflage Jutsu!
Give up.
Die!
Kakashi? What are you doing here?
Well, I couldn't leave a weakling like you on his own, could I?
He's pretty tough for a kid. I think I'd better join you, Taisuke. Just in case.
I'll take the lead here. Back me up, Obito. Let's do this!
Obito, let's go! Is Rin okay?
Shinori!
They use genjutsu on Rin. That's why...
You have to defeat us if you want to snap her out. Simple. This one must be quite the manpower shortage. It must be crazy to send kids like you out to war.
Age doesn't matter. If you can fight, you fight. That's the ninja way of life. Our training system is worlds apart from yours, I guess.
Everything you say pisses me off. You know that. Ninja art! Camouflage Jutsu! Shinori! Ninja art! Camouflage Jutsu!
Shinori! Think again! Shinori!
Heartbreaker!
Okay, let's go!
Don't ease up just because they're kids. I just let my guard down for a second, that's all. Still, definitely more than your average kid.
Finish this. You think you're hot stuff, huh?
Leave it to me.
The little brat is really tough.
Kakashi!
I can handle it.
See ya.
Kakashi!
Damn it!
Kakashi, are you okay? Your eye.
I'm not dead yet. Just stay focused, Obito.
We can use this to our advantage. I'll finish both of them now.
I can never back up what I say. I always rely on everyone for help. But still, there's one thing that I want to make sure I can back up.
Die! Your eyes.
Obito, you've awakened your Sharingan.
I'm going to save my friends.
Huh? Whoa, whoa, seriously?
Ready? Obito?
You bet!
Kakashi, Obito.
We're here to save you, Rin. You're safe now.
You rescued the hostage and let your guard down. Don't you think it's a bit early to relax, you little leaf brats? Earth-style Rockbreaker!
This is bad. Run to the exit! Are you okay, Rin? Kakashi?
Obito!
No! Don't bother. It's no use, Kakashi. I think I'm done for.
Obito!
No! But why?
Damn it! Why? If I had listened to you when you first said we should go after Rin, then this would never have happened. Some leader, some Jonin I am.
Oh yeah, I forgot. I never gave you a gift to congratulate you on becoming a Jonin, Kakashi. I've been trying to come up with something good. And just now, I got an idea. Don't worry, it's not some lame gift you can't use. I want you to have my Sharingan. I don't care what people back home say. You are a great Jonin. I truly believe that. Take this, please. I'm going to die now, but I'll become one of your eyes. I'll see what the future holds. Take Rin and go. More reinforcements are coming.
But Obito,
just go. Rin.
Earth style, earthquake slam.
Rin, grab onto me, quick!
Damn it.
Kakashi, protect Rin.
Damn it. Damn it. Damn it. Damn it!
Let's go!
Am I dead? Wait.
Looks like you're awake.
Sensei, why?
This kunai is a marker for my transportation technique.
What about the enemies?
I took care of them.
What about Rin? Where's Rin?
I'm sorry I didn't make it in time, Kakashi. Rin told me everything.
The Third Great Ninja War. This long, drawn-out conflict came to an end after taking the lives of many nameless ninja. At the same time, it carved the names of a number of heroes into ninja history. The Battle of Kanabi Bridge. On that day, two heroes were born in the Hidden Leaf Village, each with their own Sharingan. The name of one is carved on a tombstone, while the other is known far and wide as Kakashi of the Sharingan. However, with the passage of time, even tales of heroism can unfold into cold, heartless reality. The fighting, the pain, the hatred. It goes on and on, forever.
Where am I?
Somewhere halfway between life and death. Child of Uchiha.
Your eyes. It can't be. You're from the Uchiha clan too?
Well, if you can feel pain, it means you are still alive.
So you saved me? Thank you.
You can thank me later. You see, I intend to make you pay me back in full.
Okay, what do I need to do? I need to get back to the Hidden Leaf Village. We're in the middle of a war. And now that I've finally awakened my Sharingan, I'll be much better at protecting my allies.
Protecting your allies?
What?
You will not be able to go on working as a ninja with that body. Wake up. Nothing in this world goes the way it should.
Would you shut up already? I don't want to stay here forever.
Enough. Neither of us can get out of here, not with these bodies.
Just who are you?
I am the ghost of the Uchiha. Madara Uchiha.
Madara? But Madara already died ages ago.
Then I suppose I am a relic from the past. It is true.
If I was not receiving a steady supply of chakra from that statue back there, I would be dead in an instant. I am cheating death.
Why would you capture a half-dead kid like me?
We are going to break the cycle of cause and effect. Create a world with only victors, with only peace, with only love. A world that contains nothing but those things.
Why should I care? Look, I just want to go back to my village, okay?
If you want to die, that is your choice. But I shall take that eye of yours before you do.
Why do you want my eye? You already have your own!
And I am still missing a right eye. The Sharingan's true power is unleashed when the left and right come together, you see.
So, that means if I stand shoulder to shoulder with Kakashi, I'll get even stronger. Then we'll really be able to keep Rin safe. Just another reason why I need to get out of here. Just wait, you two. I'm still alive.
I leave the rest to you.
It's no use trying to act tough and hide your injuries. I've already seen them all.
Rin.
He said her name again!
Look, what the heck are you doing?
I just saw that you had started mumbling about Rin again, so I got curious as to what kind of dream you were having.
He always looks like such a loser when he's doing that. It's quite funny.
He even drools sometimes.
Hey, quit laughing, Gudu Gudu.
Sorry.
It's been a while since I first got here. The first time I saw you, I was scared to death. You're puppets who were created from the statue, right?
To us, you look like the real puppet.
Yeah, you're human, yet half of your body is artificial, just like ours.
Worried about Madara?
He went on and on about breaking the cycle of cause and effect or whatever, and then he goes to sleep forever.
Oh, didn't you understand what Madara was talking about?
Basically, his idea is to chuck out all the bad stuff in the world and run away to a dream world where everything's good. Since it's a dream world, you can do whatever you like. You can even bring dead people back to life.
What? Now that just sounds ridiculous.
Maybe to you.
Shut up! You're way stupider than me.
Bingo!
Jeez, I don't know if you're making fun of me or if you're the idiot. But I guess there's no point in worrying about that now. I just need to get used to this body as quickly as possible. Come on, you guys, time to get to work.
Okay, more rehab, right?
I take it you're ready?
Of course!
All right, let's fight! I'm gonna go all out this time. Get ready! Fire
something! Oh, have a mercy, you know.
I told you before we started. I'm going all out! Fire something!
We don't dwell on the past.
Here I go! Where do I put up
with this? Fire something!
What's your point? You don't know anything about Kakashi.
Yeah.
Ring. That's all I need to talk about. Actually makes you sound pretty lame.
Ooh, she's the real one! Oh, well, aren't you clever? I feel like I'm even tougher now than I ever was.
So, Jim, half of your body is composed of special cells.
Confidence in myself now. It feels good. I've gotten more used to it than before. I really feel at home in my body now. No more awkwardness. Rin, Kakashi. We'll be together again soon.
Oh no!
Huh?
I just went outside for a minute and saw that Rin person you keep talking about. She's in serious trouble.
What happened?
She and that Kakashi guy are surrounded by a bunch of hidden mist ninja.
You still can't break that rock yet.
But I've got to go help Rin and Kakashi.
Where my body, then?
But you work for Madara, right? Are you sure you're all right with this?
You want to help your friends, don't you?
Thanks, Gudaguda. Okay! I'm grateful to you for helping me. But yes, I'm leaving now. I have to. Okay, take me straight there.
Okay, leave the navigation to me. My allies are standing guard all over the world. It'll be a cinch.
How does it look?
Pretty bad. They keep talking about hidden mist experiments. I don't really get it. But there are a couple of dozen of them surrounding Rin and Kakashi.
What is Minato-sensei doing?
Who?
I said, what do you think you're doing, Yellow Flash of the Leaf?
I think he's wrapped up in another mission. He's nowhere nearby.
Just when we need him most. Kakashi, you promised. Please. You've got to protect Rin. I'll be right beside you soon. Rin?
No. That's spray from the collision. Rin and Kakashi are in there. What's your plan?
Isn't it obvious? I'm gonna charge straight in! What the... Why am I seeing things? There's no way that actually happened! Kakashi and I were supposed to... protect her!
What an idiot! He's all alone!
Take him out! Jutsu, right?
Ah!
Nothing in this world goes the way it should.
Since it's a dream world, you can do whatever you like. You can even bring dead people back to life.
Rain, we'll be together again. I'll make a world where we can be together again. I'm going to break the cycle. That's why I decided to come back.
Do you think that anyone saw you?
I'm the only witness. Obito annihilated every last one of them. But it looks like he spared Kakashi. He was unconscious, though, so he didn't see anything.
Still attached to your old ally, are you?
No. I just didn't care about him. Doesn't matter to me whether he lives or dies in this world. He'll join us in the new world we create. So will we. Madara, show me how to create the dream world.
You do not need to thank me anymore. This way, as of today, you are our savior. The dream world is extremely simple to create. All you need to do is take everyone into the genjutsu world I have created. But you need to use the moon to magnify the scale of the jutsu. Yes. Let us see. First, I need to educate you about the Sage of the Six Paths and the Ten Tails. And then, about my project, Tsukinome. In a previous battle, I obtained some of Hashirama's DNA and transplanted it into my own body. And then, when I was on the brink of death, I awakened my Rinnegan. At the same time, I also broke a certain seal. I summoned the Gedo statue, the empty vessel of the Ten Tails from the moon. Then, I quickly used the statue as a medium to cultivate more of Hashirama's DNA. The result was this. I transferred my will into these beings. They are half me. Now, get to work. Until I can be reborn, you are Madara Uchiha.
What do you want?
I'm going to extract the Nine Tails from you and crush the leaf. Now, come on out, Nine Tails.
Did you notice me?
I am your opponent. And you're done for. He got away so fast.
My old sensei is still powerful. But I'm faster now.
You shall not escape.
Who are you? Why are you attacking the Leaf?
What good would it do if I told you? You'll all be finished in no time anyway. There's no hope for you.
Village. As far as I know, there's only one person who fits. Don't tell me.
What do you think? The shape of our will changes what we ninja are capable of. Now do you get it? My will is a completely different one from yours.
The longer I'm caught up, the more damage is given.
If I can't protect anyone.
What are you talking about? Hey, right here!
Good question.
Let's go! Just about it. Let's go! Why are you attacking the Leaf?
Oh, because I want to. And because of that. Does this mean that I still have a path to choose? But no matter what I choose, my destination won't change. My will shall never change.
Too late for everything.
Is the village distracting you or the children? Either way, since you can't seem to concentrate on the battle, you're going to die. I won.
Flying Raiju, level 2.
I expected no less of you, Forth. You actually managed to damage me. But in the end, everything will bend to my will. I shall rule this world. There are plenty of ways to go about it. The Ninetales came out completely uncontrolled. Is that a problem? The Hidden Leaf has been completely devastated. For a while, they'll be too busy fixing up the village to do anything else.
I see. And while they're distracted, we move.
We have a lot to prepare for Project Tsukinomi. We could do with the great nations looking the other way for the time being. Let's go.
This world is pitch black. Minato-sensei. I'm sick of this. I don't care. This world anymore.
Obito, is it really you?
If you survived, then why didn't you?
My survival doesn't matter now. But if you truly want a reason, it's probably because you let Rin die.
This should be fun. Obito.
Who the hell is this?
Naruto Uchiha!
You're rather late.
This is the first exercise I've had in a while. It took some time to get used to it again. But that's all over now.
But I thought you were fighting with that grandma's team!
Didn't you hear me? I said it was over.
Impossible.
Damn it!
Here. This is yours.
No dead guy's gonna boss me around!
I'll capture the 8 tails and the 9 tails. You deal with the other two.
Ah!
You're a hero, aren't you?
Shut up! I don't want you to fall for that!
It seems your strength outstrips you.
Think with me, put him up! Tail beast planetary rust and shut again!
But compared to Hashirama, you were as fragile as an earthenware. You are no match for me.
I'll do it!
This is entertaining! This feeling. It reminds me of him. But you still cannot touch me. You are not Hashirama.
Enough crazy talk!
You miss! Just another Jinchuriki.
Come on, Kakashi. Pick up the pace.
Why would you team up with someone like Madara?
Why don't you just shut up? You're nothing but talk.
Is this all about Rin? I know. I failed to keep my promise to you. You're right. I am trash. But you're a hero of the Hidden Leaf. You don't need to sink to the same level.
This is reality. Whatever side you're on, every ninja who survives ends up as trash. You and I are perfect examples of that. No one can escape the cycle that the garbage in this world produces. So I'm going to rebuild it.
No.
Naruto!
A shadow clone.
You guys are so annoying. I can't even put it into words. So, I'm gonna teach you something instead. I am not garbage! And I'm never gonna be garbage! I won't let it happen. I won't let you kill any of my friends!
I'm not gonna let anyone kill a friend of mine. Sorry, Naruto. I'm the one who taught you that. What Obito taught me. But... I was about to lose it again. Obito. The ideals you carried are still here. Right next to me. All I need to do now is protect Naruto. Come on, Guy. Naruto, we'll defeat Obito. For the sake of the future.
Right!
Yeah!
Sees me through this battle. I'm good. You okay over there, Naruto?
Me and I are keeping him at bay.
We've got to finish off Obito fast and get over there to help.
I'm ready to
fight. I'm serious now.
Now I can really see.
Connect us to the future, which means...
Lightning Blade!
If we could just take Obito out of the picture for a while, we'll have a chance to stop the Ten Tails. To chase him down.
On it.
What the?
Let's blow him to hell before he can recover.
Yeah.
Fire.
Yeah.
Is that it?
Yes. That's it. For this world.
Whoa!
What?
That's...
Don't tell me.
Ah, it's here. The Ten Tails.
The Ten Tails.
I thought the statue's bad chakra disappeared.
It has no emotions or ideas. It's the very embodiment of the nature energy that flows through the world.
I intended to capture them by the time the Ten Tails was resurrected, but they are stronger than I expected.
Look out! It's kicking off!
Naruto, pull in Kakashi and Gai.
Okay!
Listen up. First, you need to keep away and watch it. Coordinate your attacks with how it moves to do as much damage as possible. Now, let's move.
Okay. guess if there's ever going to be a time we can relax with this.
You see, brother?
Why can't you see?
No matter how much you struggle, it's time.
Hoping to save the Ten Tails, but they've forced our hand. Time for a little attack.
For me.
Stop, Naruto. Shadow clones are useless now.
You're all just a bunch of headless chickens.
Who's a chicken now, huh? What you're looking at here is the Allied Shinobi Forces Jutsu! This jutsu is gonna smash you! The world is
going to end here.
Orders to Allied Shinobi Forces from HQ.
This is where the battle really begins, everyone. Carry out the mission as planned and corner the Ten Tails.
Come on, everyone, let's go!
Yeah! Earthstar!
Now's the time for your...
Allied Shinobi Forces
don't really think that was enough to end this, do you?
Damn it!
That's the direction of.
Here it comes.
It's aiming to take out our HQ. That sounds like one of your tactics. So, there's not enough time to escape. What should we do?
We just keep doing everything we can until the very end. Inuichi, make contact with everyone on the battlefield. Everyone, listen up.
Now we have crushed their head. Basic combat strategy. Now, what next?
We continue. We continue showing them despair. In minute detail. Wood style, cutting sprigs jutsu!
There's too many.
What can we do?
Stop!
No. It's too late.
Neji, no.
Naruto, you know that Lady Hinata would die for you, which means your life is part of a bigger picture. I think my life was part of that picture, too.
Why? Why you? Why here? Why would you go that far?
Because you... said I was a genius.
Neji!
Neji!
Come on, Neji! Don't give up on us! Neji! No. This can't be.
I thought no one was going to kill your friends. This is going to happen again and again. All the things you casually said, all your ideals will turn into lies. What do you have in this reality, Naruto? But who said we have to live in reality? Just come over to our side already.
Remember what Neji said to you? About your life being part of a bigger picture. Do you know what he meant by that? He meant never letting an ally die. There were no lies in his words or his ideals. Neji made it true. In his heart. It's not just you, Naruto. We're all connecting our lives through the same feelings that are in our hearts. Makes us friends. But if we give up on that ideal now, everything Neji's done will have been in vain. That's what it really means to let an ally die. So come. Stand tall with me, Naruto. Stay strong and don't break your word. I won't either. That's my ninja way.
I knew that. It isn't just Mom and Dad. I'm not alone at all! Hinata, thank you. It's all thanks to you standing by me.
Okay, enough.
Watch this. Let's do this, Hinata.
Okay.
What's that?
The Nine Tails Chakra.
Well, well. That little brat can pass off chakra from the Nine Tails.
Not like it's going to change anything.
Shadow Clone Jutsu!
You've learned nothing from your ally's death, have you? You're nothing but a child.
Yes, Neji's gone. But Neji's still alive, inside of us.
Allow me to let you in on a little secret. I'm the one who created that bond. You should also know that it's a powerful curse.
With my friends, and I don't want them broken.
You really are a child. If you consider the pain of your allies' deaths to be bonds, then what's the use in protecting them?
Huh? Quit trying to be a smartass! When it comes to my friends, I'm prepared to bear any kind of pain! I'm never gonna give up on them! Yeah, maybe it's selfish, but the thing that would hurt me most is if my friends weren't here with me! Period!
So, what exactly is your point?
Huh?
I commend you for pulling us down. You did well. It doesn't change anything in the end, just makes things trickier.
The one and only bond between myself and the Ten Tails has been broken. It's out of control now.
Okay, time to finish that thing.
Ah, I see you had the same idea as me.
Naruto, hold the fort here!
Kakashi-sensei!
Yes, this is where the real fun begins.
The time has come. For the sake of the ninja world, some fight with their allies. For the sake of the ninja world, some run together through darkness, while two men gaze at the future. In the next chapter, the United Front.
Sakura, Sasuke, let's go!
Okay.
Got it.